Hey guys, it is JMO here. Welcome to episode 12 of the Hardcore Iron Man Progress series. So between the last episode and this episode, I've got 119 construction from using all the stuff in my bank. The only skills I have left for max is archaeology, divination, invention, crafting, thieving, herblore, combat, or melee combat, and runecrafting. So not too bad. Probably going to have a crack at archaeology, divination. Haven't done archaeology in a while. But before then, I wanted to get some death touch darts, turn off auto retaliate. And I want to quickly do 4 Calphite Kings. Let's see if I get lucky and get anything good. Where is he? Yeah. Yeet. Would be pretty cool if I got like a good drop. Maybe he'll probably spawn again really soon. Let's just take this damaged chitin. Yeet. Don't like that he did damage to me, but I don't imagine he can one hit me, so it's all good. Really, just fucking dragon hides. I don't need those. More. I got these from the Halloween event, killing Lucian. If you don't kill Lucian, you're wasting lots of free kills on Calphite King or whatever you want to kill. Torstal's garbage. Alright, let's hope we get at least a Drygor in this last kill. Otherwise, I think we can be understandably pretty disappointed coming away from this. And give me... I'd love like a Drygor... rapier. Damn. Worth a try. Okay, so since completing 99 Slayer, I can actually get a full Slayer Helm upgrade because I have 600 points. There's not really anything else I kind of want. This is irrelevant. Already got this. Herbicide would be... Oh, these are tool belts. Those would actually be quite good, but I think the main thing right now should be the Slayer Helm upgrade. So now I have the Mighty, and I think the last one's like reinforced or something like that. Welcome back. It's been a very long time since I've recorded, but I've just been grinding out the Halloween event for quite a while. So I mostly just do the runecrafting or the crafting pillar, and then I chuck all the bonus experience into herblore or agility. As you can see, I've still got a heap of construction. It is double rainbow or whatever the promotion is, so I'm going to use the double experience, and I'm going to go get 120 construction right now, because it's been a while, but I think it's time that I can get it, because I've been just storing some lamps for a while. Oh, I meant to use all. There we go. The next skill I'm going to get to 120 is, let's go, agility. Bam, 8.5 mil, nice. I swear I had some more lamps. I guess not. That's 120 construction. Let's go get the cape, and I'm going to see if I can keepsake it as well. Or actually, I don't need to keepsake it, because it'll probably be the best cape I can use. It's not a great looking cape, but it'll do for now. Welcome back. The Halloween event's over. We are on 926. As you can see, it's a little bit crisper. Let me actually fix this texture. Size. I don't like that one. So as I said, yeah, Halloween event is finished. I think I managed to get like 70k tokens by the end, 66. So this means I can buy one. I can't buy either. Welcome back. I ended the Halloween event with a perfect amount of 100,000, so that means I can buy either the cremation or the herb burning. I think herb burning's better. It gives less experience for fire making, but overall, I don't really think prayer is going to be too difficult, whereas herb lore, it would be nice to kind of do that slowly. So I'm going to buy that one, and I'm going to redeem it. Oh, it was only 50. I forgot we fixed it. So I can buy both of them. So now if I go to the donor zone, I'll show you what I can do with these. So if I come over here, let's get some herbs. So if I go clean, spirit weeds, I'll probably never use those. Now I can just chuck all the herbs I don't need and just AFK it like this, and I'm getting fairly decent, like 1k XP drops from each one. And it's not great, but it's not too bad for herbs that I wouldn't want to turn into actual potions, which are a few of these. I don't know which, but I'll probably make a bunch of overloads and then decide. my cache is fucked up. I also got a bunch of stuff from the event that I didn't use, so I will use all of these on herb lore as well. These were from the event, so I'll allow it. Whereas, like, all the lamps and stuff from Treasure Hunter, which we'll have a look at now, they can only go to one of my already 99 skills. So we'll just take all those, and we'll use those on, what did we say, we were getting to 120? I forgot what it was. Was it Hunter? I think it was Hunter. So we'll go Hunter, and we'll use all these on Hunter as well. We'll just claim those tokens. We'll leave that stuff. Oh god, I didn't realize I had all those. So Halloween event, really good for runecrafting. I got to 76, which is one level off blood runes, which is good. Thieving is at 89, herb lore is at 80. The other skills you can train was divination. I got that to 91 just through the event. Didn't really have to train that myself. I also got the agility pet while I was using my silverhawk, so let me claim that. I will never use it, it's an ugly pet. I also did my penguins, as usual. Got a bunch of fortunates there just waiting. I don't really need to use them right now, so there's no point. I'm just going to store them until I can actually get a alchemical onyx or whatever it's called. Penguins, I've been saving my points for a fair bit, I think. Let's see how many I have. Yep, 1644. So let me buy all those, and I'll enable some double experience. And let's use this all on Hunter and see how high we get. 16 mil, so that should put me to 107. 108. Not too bad at all. I'm going to use all my penguin points on lamps like that and just use them on Hunter. I don't really think it's worth otherwise. Ooh, a large cashback. This should give me, what, like 50 mil? 18 mil, never mind. I actually did get a fair bit of money from the event, so that's pretty good. Won't be struggling for money for quite a while. As you can see, I'm currently geared, construction cape, I'm currently geared for melee. So when I want to, I will go use this axe to level my melee stats there. They've fallen quite far behind my defense, so I'll have to catch up there. I also got crafting to 95, I'm not sure if I did that on video. I used some of my protein hides, which I don't know where they are there. Looks like I used pretty much all of them. So, ooh, heaps of herbs and secondary boxes. Let's open all these as well. Oh, I can only open 100 at a time. All of it goes to the bank, so it's all good. Let's see. And if we now go clean, yeah, good stack. And as I said, like, some of these that I don't need are bucks, I don't know what they're for. Toad Flax, I don't know if they're any use that's decent for prey renewals. But yeah, like all the ones I don't need, I can just use on the Cremator and do that. And same goes for bones now. I can take over these Frost Dragon bones to the Donor Zone, and I can get the best experience in the game for Prayer, as well as a fair amount of Firemaking XP as well. So 4.3k Firemaking, and I don't have Prayer here. 6.7k Prayer. This is with double, so don't take it too seriously. But yeah, that will be really good for the future. Oh, I did actually see someone said you can't do that, so I may as well use the rest. But yeah, so 926 is released. That means Rex Matriarchs are out. We also have the ability to add a bunch of new content. Skilling Porter 7 is here. I think it's 7. Yep, 7. Incandescent and Dragonstone Necklaces. That transports 50, I think. But yeah, there's heaps of content to add. And I'm going to be slowly working my way through it. I've got to get back into Iron Chode. Been taking a bit of a step back for the Halloween event, and kind of just AFKing that every day instead of actually playing the game. But now I think it's time we get back into it.